Hello, this is Kurt Worley, FX strategist and trader coach at fxbootcamp.com. Today is Thursday, December 13th, 2012. As I speak, it is a few minutes after 10 a.m. New York time. What you're looking at right now is a four-hour chart for the Euro-USD currency pair on the Awanda MT4 trading platform. I'm going to highlight the recent move up on this pair over the course of this week. It's been up, up, up for this pair. Yesterday, after London closed, we had the announcement by the Fed of more policy easing, specifically more quantitative easing. The Fed's going to be purchasing more Treasury securities after the expiration of a so-called Operation Twist program. More specifically and more surprisingly, the Fed announced so-called threshold guidance, which I can get to in later videos to explain that. But the bottom line is this. The Euro-USD did rise immediately after that Fed announcement after yesterday's London close. Euro topped that around the 1.31 psychological level, which I'll discuss in a little bit on a 15-minute chart for the euro. And notice the highs earlier this month closer to 1.3120-ish up in here. Anyway, the euro did drop during the course of today's London session. The euro found support near that 1.3045 level, which I discussed in a video alert from yesterday. Again, you see the price action earlier this month around the 30-45 area there. And the euro's back up as I speak right now. The euro nearing 130.85, approaching perhaps that 1.31 level again. So again, the euro been more up than down all week. Let's take a closer look at the shorter-term chart here. Here's a 15-minute chart. The euro still hung up around the 30.80 area right now. This has been a tough nut to crack for the euro over the past couple hours here. But the point I want to make was this. We're a little more than an hour away from the start of a press conference. U.S. House Speaker Boehner due to address the media about the so-called U.S. fiscal cliff negotiations. And so that's if there's anything that could affect the euro, or more specifically the dollar, between now and London close, which is about 90 minutes from now, it would be that. So House Speaker Boehner's comments about fiscal cliff could certainly affect this pair, and more broadly speaking, affect the dollar. How could that look? What could that look like? Well, if Boehner expresses optimism, shows some encouraging signs about how the fiscal cliff negotiations are going, that could mean some dollar weakness, which obviously means up for this pair. On the other hand, if Boehner, as he's done recently, expressed some concerns about the fiscal cliff negotiations, the dollar could actually rally. So here's a trade plan. Option one. Let me activate the drawing tool here. Option one, given how much of a struggle the euro has had with this 30.80 area, that's certainly one option for a euro short. If you're betting on Boehner, for example, expressing concerns about the fiscal cliff negotiations and any subsequent dollar rally, which we could get on the back of those concerns expressed by Boehner, that could mean down for this pair. And it's certainly a short, not a crazy idea, considering the double top we had with yesterday's high and today's early London session high, both near 131. Or you wait for the euro to rise a little more and look to short closer to the 131 level. And again, what you're hoping for is a combination of either A, Boehner's comments expressing concerns about the fiscal cliff, the negotiations benefiting the dollar, which means down for this pair, and or B, we see some profit taking my European traders looking to close perhaps some euro long positions before the end of the European trading day. So the trade plan, short around 30.80 to the 131 level, short somewhere in this zone, targeting at least that 130.45 zone we've talked about in the past couple of videos.